Dave, the scoreline says 6-1, but I want your assessment of how your side played.
Well, in patches. Soft as crap in others. We gifted them 2 goals from set pieces. The second goal wasn't great. Some of their goals was good play. You hold your hand up, still preventable. But by and large, we gave as good as we got. But goals change games. Goals change games. So as much as I can say that Aston Villa fully deserved their victory, they approached it well, and all credit to Dean and his players. We helped them at times. Having said that, I thought we did okay. You know, the golfing class was there at times, significantly, certainly towards the end. I thought in that first half, for long periods, we were okay, but then helped them, gifted them goals. Disappointed.
What about the goal that you got choked off and it was just 1-0 at that stage? How did you see that? Because that could have been a big turning point of the game. It was definitely offside at the end, through Owen Dale finishing
it. I've been told he was offside. I haven't seen it back. I don't know if it was still going in anyway. I don't know. You know, that's the bit of luck that you need. And, you know, there's a red card at the end, fair play. If I don't send him off, wouldn't have changed the game. You know, I'm not complaining about the ref, you know. But it's them little moments that you need in games against opponents as good as Aston Villa. So, quite get it. Probably didn't deserve any either. You make your own luck. You know, the way we defended 2 corners was abysmal. We didn't start the game well again. That's third time in 6, 7, 8 games. We've conceded in the first 5 minutes, never mind 15. And we've got to put a stop to that. So like I say, we've helped them at times. We've looked good at times. We've been soft at times. I have to say, we totally deserved the goal. That's one thing we did deserve. So yeah, I think a bit of a mixed bag, but a great barometer for our young players.
Yeah, in fact, there's not many teams in the Football League like Crewe Alexandra would give an 18-year-old teenager his first professional start against a Premier League side. And how well did he catch the eye for you in Rio?
He was terrific, wasn't he? He was terrific. He was one of our better players. I wouldn't have thrown him in if he wouldn't have done well in training, or we felt he would have been phased in any way. Kenny asked me before the game, how did you sleep last night? And I went, yeah, fine. As if it were like a stupid question. You know, and that's credit to him. He's got a great character and he's got a bright future. He's got a real bright future, real.
It's great for him to get that under his belt. And what else will it have done to quite a lot of your younger players playing against, you know, good Premier League players, and bringing on the likes of Jack Grealish and giving a £15 million a debut and £11 million a debut as well?
Is that what it was? Listen, it's a great experience for him. You know, and I've just said to him, mate, I want more nights like this, more days like this, and you only do that by being successful in the league. You know, because it might be, I don't know, FA Cup round 3, might be a playoff, don't know, whatever, might be check a train, quarter final, I've no idea. But it only happens when you understand that you've got to be a winner. And they get the nights like tonight because they were winners at Middlesbrough. And that's only one game, I get it. But we've got to do this more often.
Good.
So, yeah.